cooler, no more rain, and also a little bit windy today. All the details on your forecast coming right up.
Now on Good Morning Augusta, heavy storms blowing through the CSRA. We're serving the damage. Plus the latest on the canceled XPR concert series. We hear from people who say they still haven't gotten their money back. And later, millions of people could get COVID-19 later this year. We'll explain. Details as your number one source for local weekend morning news starts right now.
Live from Television Park, this is Good Morning Augusta on WGBF News Channel 6.
Good morning, Sunshine. Thank you for joining us. It's great to see you. I'm Sean Gavichnuk. Coverage you can count on begins with investigators making an arrest in two unsolved murders that took place back in April. 33-year-old Kelvin Lewis is charged with two counts of murder following the deaths of 72-year-old Johnny Coleman and 29-year-old Brittany Doty. Coleman was found shot to death on Old Savannah Road. Doty was found dead on Copeland Lane. We're working to get Lewis's mugshot for you. Some local high school seniors are getting ready to start their future careers as teachers. 13 seniors at Thompson High School took part in a signing day yesterday. They pledged to start the path to become an educator. Students say they are excited to be able to continue in the footsteps of teachers who came before them.
I always knew I wanted to be a teacher, a future educator, ever since like the ninth grade. I had a coach, his name was Coach Wright, and he taught mathematics and coach track, so I knew I wanted to kind of like be like him.
I've always wanted to follow the footsteps of teachers like Ms. Watley and Ms. Thomas, my math teacher, and make an impact on other students and be able to be that teacher they can come to.
And of course, congratulations to all of them. Some people say they are still waiting to get their money back from those concerts that were planned during Masters Week. Our Mary.
C4 Live, the XPR Augusta organizers, have a five-year lease on Lake Olmsted through the Augusta Economic Development Authority. They've agreed to invest $1.8 million into the stadium over 5 years in exchange for use of the stadium 80 days out of the year. The Development Authority said C4 Live is upholding its end of the bargain, and that lease will continue.
You can see where they've gutted much of the inside of the stadium. They've tore out part of the stands. There's been a lot of mold remediation that was done because that stadium had sat there for quite a few years.
Commissioner Brandon Garrett says they did make an effort to be ready in time for the concerts. It just didn't pan out. Although the partnership between C4 Live and Augusta will continue, some ticket holders say the concert has hurt the city's reputation.
We had a lot of people from out of town here, and we're supposed to be putting our best foot forward in the community. And whether or not it had anything to do with the community directly, we're still going to take a black eye on this. Who wants to participate in a concert that you can't get a refund on?
It's going to be really a struggle for XPR Augusta to ever be able to put on any shows in the future because I certainly will not buy tickets through them.
C4 Live says all tickets will be refunded, but after more than a month, many ticket holders are left holding the bag.
And I'd want to know why they're not giving us our money back. What are they doing with our money?
C4 Live tells News Channel 6 in a statement, "We continue processing refunds as quickly as possible. We will share an update once all refunds have been completed." In Augusta, Mary Calkins, WGBS News Channel 6.
We saw some scary weather here at Television Park during our 4 p.m. newscast yesterday. This was shot in our back parking lot. The weather left many in our area without power, and some with no place to stay, safe place to stay, last night. A mother and her three children are displaced after damage to their apartment. It happened at Falcon Crest Apartments. A tree fell onto a child's bedroom. Here's our Ashley Jones.
Asia Spate and her three children live in this apartment complex behind me. She says that heavy rain and hailstorm caused a tree to fall into her son's room, causing extensive damage there and also more damage to the outside of the home.
This is all my kids. This is all we have. And at the end of the day, you know, I'm just glad nobody was hurt. But what me and my kids supposed to do now?
This is what Asia and her children came home to Friday evening after that heavy hailstorm.
My kids was with my mom, so my mom needed help bringing the kids in the house. So when I came in the house, my son seen a tree and it was still raining, so he's getting poured on and it's flooded in the bottom.
That's when Asia went upstairs to check out the damage for herself.
And the whole ceiling fell on a fresh bed. I just bought the bed. I just bought the mattress. We've been having problems with this same apartment since I moved here. I've only been here 30 days.
She says she's been having issues with leaking in that apartment before the storm even hit, so she knew the roof needed some work. She says after looking at the damages from the storm, she went to the front office asking for help.
I didn't want to open the door. I had to kick the door to make them understand that it was an emergency. And once they knew it was an emergency and I asked them, what does the complex do at this point, they laughed and said, unfortunately, they do not have the inventory.
Keith says she works for this complex painting the apartments.
And I know you have something. So at the end of the day, God blessed me because I'm alive. My kids are alive because I could have been in that bed. My kids could have been laying beside me in that bed, and we can't move that fast. That tree would have hurt us. So at the end of the day, you know, God is good, and it'll be okay. I just hope it'll be okay, at least.
News Channel 6 will continue to follow this story and let you know about repairs, and we'll also let you know how you can help Asia and her family. Here in Augusta, I'm Ashley Jones, WJBF, News Channel 6.
I'm glad she's okay, Ashley. Thank you. Jenna, hopefully nothing like that in our forecast for today.
Exactly, Sean. We're happy to see beautiful blue skies to kick off this Saturday morning. Here's a look at our Jiffy Loop Skype Network cam over at the airport. Conditions are much improved already today. Temperatures are still pretty mild into the 60s. 61 at Bushfield, 63 at Daniel Field, and 60 over in Aiken with sunny skies to start off the morning. Winds are coming in from the northwest, a little bit breezy, 9 miles per hour in Augusta, 8 in Aiken, 6 in Barnwell. And as we look at satellite and radar, notice we had a few clouds earlier. Those are starting to clear out, but more clouds to come along with that trough and possibly some drizzle later on in the afternoon. But the cold front that brought us all that rain and storms yesterday is now pushing off the coast. So no more severe weather for this weekend. Here's our storm reports from yesterday, though. Notice throughout the metro area, a lot of hail and wind reports. Also, those wind reports across the entire southern CSRA from the Wrightsville area all the way over through Bamberg. Our northwestern counties fortunately dodged the worst of those storms. Notice from Washington down to Sparta, not seeing any storm reports over there. As we talked about earlier, we definitely saw some pretty significant hail throughout the Augusta area. Seeing a picture sent in from Augusta, North Augusta, and Belvedere. But luckily for our morning, definitely much calmer conditions, warming up to 70 degrees by 10 a.m. A partly cloudy and pretty windy day. A very nice Mother's Day in store for us. And by next week, we'll finally start to warm up again. More details on your forecast coming up. But back to you, Sean.
Calm weather is fine with me, John. Thank you. Augusta University will host a free health clinic. A variety of services will be offered, like dental exams, mental health, and vision screenings. The clinic is open to anyone from 8 until 4, and it will be at the AU Medical Office Building on Harper Street. You can vote early today for the upcoming Georgia primary elections. Both Richmond and Columbia County, the 38th annual Johnston Peach Bloom Festival will kick off today. It will showcase great entertainment, arts and crafts, food, a parade, an area for children, and more. The festival begins at 9. The parade will start at 10:30, and the parade grand marshal for this year is Ellen Geddes, who represented the U.S. in the Tokyo Paralympics in 2021. A baker moments away from having a stroke made some tough decisions. Jane Jones is the No Sugar Baker, and she joins us to share her story and one of her recipes so that you can continue the Cinco de Mayo celebration. Hey, Jane. Ooh, that looks good. See you in a bit. Cinco de Mayo was Thursday, but the celebration can still go on. Of course, it's one of the biggest celebrations of the year, filled with food, drinks, and of course, fun. So why not make this year's celebration a bit healthier and cut out all the sugar that leads to a number of health issues? And joining me today is Jane Jones. She's known as America's No Sugar Baker, and she's here to share some of her favorite recipes that have no sugar, but she promises it still tastes great. Jane, thank you so much for joining me today.
Oh my gosh, absolutely.
All right, so before we get into your recipes, you have an amazing, incredible story about how you landed in the ER on your 45th birthday.
Yeah, you know, I had no idea I was very sick. I thought I had a flu. Instead, I got diagnosed with big T word diabetes. I'm embarrassed to tell you my blood sugar this day was over 600, wanting to be batting about 100. My blood pressure was 289 over 189. I lost my eyesight for 3 weeks. 6 months later, here's the great part, 6 months later, insulin free, diabetic medicine free, 6 pounds lighter, and that vision I lost was back in 2020. All because I completely eliminated sugar from my diet, but I didn't give up the taste and I didn't give up the treats. I thought tacos, nachos, I thought margaritas were all out of my life. Boy, was I ever wrong.
Well, that's great. So, what are you sharing with us today?
Well, here's what I'm going to do. So, you know what? Like I said, we're going to have, we're still having the party. We're still having the fun. Out the guilt. I have a no sugar banger watermelon salsa, which is made with tomatoes. Tomatoes are full of sugar, so I made it with watermelon salsa. I have a chicken enchilada, a chicken enchilada soup, sugar-free margaritas, a little fun. Coat your glass with low-carb potato chips. But what we're making today is a no sugar banger taco skillet. I absolutely love it because it's got all the flavors, all within a cast iron cute little pan that makes you a better guest. Go ahead and spray that. Now, you're going to use cauliflower rice. Yes, you heard me right. Cauliflower rice on the very bottom of it. You're going to add in just enough of your taco meat, right? So go ahead and ground your meat, add a little taco seasoning to it. Then I'm going to add in tomatoes, peppers, onions right on top of it. Then I'm going to throw cheese right on top of it, just like so. I'm going to bake it, right, in the cast iron at 350 for about 10 to 15 minutes, depending on your soap. And then you're going to top it with sour cream, top it with guacamole, top it with those jalapenos, grab yourself some low-carb, completely sugar-free chia chips. You're going to eat it, and you're going to get the whole awesomeness, the crunch, the goodness of Cinco de Mayo, all in a healthy bite. It's super easy. Go to nosugarbaker.com. We have all these recipes. Trust me when I say this no sugar watermelon salsa has the spice of those jalapenos along with the sweetness in that low sugar mother watermelon. It will become your absolute favorite.
And it looks great on the screen, Jane. So you released two cookbooks recently, so how can folks find them?
Oh my gosh, super easy. Just go to nosugarbaker.com. Clever, I know. Nosugarbaker.com. Both cookbooks are there. 100 recipes and both cookbooks. Hey, you know what? I'm just a lawyer who got sick. Had to find her way back into this kitchen again. Exactly what I did. And you know what? I know that 10% of the population fits into this whole diabetes kitchen with me. We can still celebrate this the healthy way.
I like it, and I'm glad you're healthy, and you're eating healthy, and you're showing us how we can do the same.
Yes, absolutely. Cheers. Go make those sugar-free margaritas.
I think I will. Jane, thank you so much for joining me. I really do appreciate it.
Oh my gosh, my pleasure. Have a great day.
You too. And Jenna is up next with your Live 5 for 6 forecast in less than 3 minutes.
Now, your most accurate forecast. WJBF Live, Viper 6.
Good Saturday morning. I'm happy to say that after all the storms yesterday, we have a much better forecast in store for us today. Right now on our Jiffy Lube Skype Network cam at the Augusta Marriott, we have some high-level clouds, some of us seeing a little bit of sunshine, 61 degrees as our temperature, and a west-southwest wind of 9 miles per hour. Visibility is fine at 10 miles. And around the CSRA, we're seeing anywhere from low 60s to mid-60s. 60 in Washington and Crawfordville, 59 in Gibson, 64 in Bamberg, and 65 down in Sylvania. For satellite and radar, you can see those clouds passing through. As we look ahead or across the two-state view, there is a cold front that brought us all that rain and storms. Notice all the lightning strikes out to sea now, so that cold front is pushing off. But we do have a trough to the north of us. That'll bring in some more cloud cover later on and possibly some areas of drizzle. But for the most part, we'll stay partly cloudy, warming up only into the upper 70s. Huge change of pace from last week. Not nearly as hot and humid today. And also, it will be windy despite the fact that we won't have any storms with the wind. 14 miles per hour sustained by the afternoon and evening with gusts as high as 25. Overall, for your Mother's Day weekend, we'll see cooler temperatures staying in the 70s as highs. Cooler and breezy today and a mix of sun and clouds tomorrow. So for your Mother's Day, I would definitely recommend having outdoor plans. It's going to be really nice. Not completely sunny, but at least temperatures will be feeling o'clock. No chance of rain, though, just saying mostly cloudy. For us, our high temperatures will continue to stay below average over the next few days into the 70s. We'll slowly but surely climb back up, though, right to around average by the middle of next week and 85 degrees by next Friday. For a future cast, notice that westerly wind bringing in some clouds later on this afternoon and early evening. As I mentioned, we could see some drizzle, but overall keeping those rain chances under 20% today. And the big story will definitely just be the winds. Notice our winds will stay up to around 25 miles per hour throughout the entire afternoon and early evening. And as we go into 7 o'clock, that's when we'll start to see those values settle down into the teens. Our highs today will be well below average. We'll be staying in those mid to upper 70s, 78 degrees in Augusta. And for tonight, also seeing cooler lows than typical. We'll be seeing a low 50s in our northern counties and mid 50s further towards the south. Overall, for your 10-day forecast, we'll be partly cloudy this weekend, staying in the 70s, a really nice Mother's Day with sunshine returning on Monday. That sun will stick around throughout the middle of the week as temperatures rise into the 80s, and by next weekend, we'll be tracking more rain and storms.
A roller coaster of temperatures, but is better than an alternative.
Yeah, we've got a little bit of everything this week, Sean.
Yes, we do. Thank you. Coming up, a tattoo shop is offering free tattoos, but here's a catch.
You didn't end now.
Hey there. Welcome back. A runner in the Long Island Marathon set a world record, so look closely in the crowd, and you'll see a dub. There he goes. He's running. His name is Wrinkles, and obviously he's not your average marathon runner. The duck who showed up at the New York Marathon last year also participated in the kids' 1K marathon in Long Island. Wrinkles, who's known as Seductive on Instagram, get it? Seductive, set a 1 kilometer dub world record of 18 minutes and 8 seconds. Someone on his Instagram page posted that the race was fun, but hard. Look at Wrinkles go.
Wow, he was putting in work. Did you see the flapping?
Yeah.
Wow, look at that. Oh my goodness.
He's a better runner than me, Jenna.
Oh, he could 100% beat me. And he has a super cool name, so good for him. He's winning in life.
Yes, he is. I think I'm going to follow him on Instagram.
Yeah, I'm definitely going to look that up. Well, now you can own a piece of historic Disneyland, like one of its famous Skyway gondolas. Or here's another, one of the old cars from the Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. Heritage Auctions is selling off part of the collection of a voice actor who did some work for Disney. He started gathering park artifacts at a young age, and now he's ready to sell. There are signs, posters, books, dolls, all sorts of Disney treasures. The bidding opens May 21st at comics.ha.com. The sale closes a day later. Wow, he's going to make a whole lot of money on that, Sean.
Have you ever been to Disney World or Disneyland?
I have. I've been to Disney in Florida, and I've been to Universal.
Oh, cool.
Which Universal's my favorite. Yeah. Harry Potter World and all that.
Yeah, I always wanted to go, but never had a chance to go. But hey, maybe I can go now, Jenna.
Oh, yeah, you do. Definitely got it. That's something you have to do at least once in life.
I'll add it to my bucket list. And coming up, a Virginia tattoo shop is giving out free tattoos, but the only catch is it has to be male-themed. Duke's Mayonnaise partnered with Yellow Bird Tattoo for the one-day giveaway on May 13th. Duke says that fans' extreme passion for the product made them a cult brand and want to reward the dedication. The free tats are limited to a selection of more than 40 pre-drawn designs and can be done in black or color.
The company's Instagram shared more intricate Duke's-themed tattoos that inspired the giveaway. All available appointments are already booked, but if you need that Mayo tattoo, you can email the shop to be put on the wait list. You know, I don't think I need the Mayo tattoo.
Okay, me either.
They're not bad. I'm looking at them, and they're pretty cool, especially the intricate ones, but I don't like Mayo, so that would be a no for me.
You don't like mayo, Jenna?
I don't.
Wow.
I don't like mayo, mustard, or ketchup. Not,
okay.
I know.
I'm not what do you like? Maybe that's the question.
I am not a picky eater when it comes to actual food. I don't consider that food.
Yeah.
You know,
okay.
It's a different category.
It's a condiment.
I like ranch.
Yeah.
That's about it.
Maybe our director, Evan, will get one because he has like 150 tattoos.
Yeah, he might as well just add that to the collection.
Might as well. I'll pay for it for you, Evan. Well, coming up on Good Morning Augusta, as COVID cases are rising across the country again, the Biden administration administration says that 100 million people could get COVID in the fall and winter. Details coming up. But first, let's head to New York, where Eva Pilgrim is standing by with a look at what's coming up on Good Morning America. Coming up on Good Morning Augusta, as COVID cases are rising across the country again, the Biden administration says that 100 million people could get COVID in the fall and winter. Details coming up. But first, let's head to New York, where Eva Pilgrim is standing by with a look at what's coming up on Good Morning America.
Coming up on GMA, that CDC investigation into a mysterious and rare hepatitis outbreak in kids. What we're learning this morning as the illness causes concern across the world after at least 109 children have gotten sick, including 5 deaths. This as COVID-19 cases and hospitalizations rise across the country. Plus, a royal reunion. Harry and Meghan and family expected to attend the Queen's Platinum Jubilee next month at Buckingham Palace as she marks 70 years on the throne. The reporter remarks from the Duke and Duchess and Her Majesty ahead of the festivities coming up. And the world's fastest sport revving up this morning for the Formula One Miami Grand Prix tomorrow. Our team is live on the track this morning with a preview of what to expect from the big event this year. It's all here ahead on GMA.
As millions of people could get COVID-19 in the fall and winter, public health leaders are signaling that the U.S. is turning another corner in the pandemic and that the continued surge might just be a part of the new normal. Here's Karina Mitchell.
A grim new warning from the Biden administration, which says as many as 100 million Americans may get sick with COVID this fall and winter. That means people who've already had COVID could get it again.
With waning immunity with Omicron, it's as contagious as it is in each new version, becoming more contagious, I think it stands to reason that we may very well get a large surge of infections.
This, as the U.S. sees yet another rise in new daily COVID infections. At least 42 states and territories have seen COVID infection rates go up by 10% or more. At least 37 states are reporting an uptick in hospitalizations. In New York City, transmission is up nearly 33% in 10 days. The city's mayor now says a return to mask and vaccine mandates is possible.
If we switch to the next level, then we would take those actions based on that, but we're not there yet.
Meantime, the FDA says they're limiting the use of the Johnson & Johnson single-shot vaccine after an investigation into reports of rare blood clots. The FDA says even though the blood clot risk is low, the two other vaccines available in the U.S. are much safer. Now, the agency is only allowing those 18 and older who don't have access to a Pfizer or Moderna vaccine or won't take them to get the J&J shot.
If you had the J&J shot a long time ago, there is no cause for panic. This is a rare side effect that happens in the days and months after the shot.
Meantime, the Biden administration continues to urge Congress to pass more than $22 billion in COVID relief funding, saying things like vaccines, treatments, and testing are at stake. Karina Mitchell, ABC News, New York.
Jenna, earlier you said we will have sun and some wind. Jenna, thank you. From 5 until 11 tonight, the Augusta Common will be transformed into a big birthday celebration for Soul Brother Number One, that's James Brown. Food trucks, vendors, kids' activities, and of course music from a number of performers will be on hand, celebrating the legacy of the Godfather of Soul. The Westaboo Lounge area, which is on the Broad Street side, will open at 1 p.m. and is free and open to the public. Celebrating a different type of hero, how one woman is serving up more than just a pretty smile to students. That's coming up next.
Live vibration.
In the pecking orders of heroes, ranking right up there with Superman and Spider-Man, are the Wonder Women of the school cafeteria. Yesterday was National School Lunch Hero Day, and we're meeting one lunch lady with plenty of sway.
School Lunch Hero Day.
Pass on some work for the kids and the staff.
And Vanessa Evans Floyd, aka Chef V, is serving up more than just that friendly smile.
We're feeding about roughly 1,000 meals and mouth cakes.
Chef V works for a company called Chartwell's K-12.
My day begins early 5:30 in the morning, beginning with breakfast for middle school, K-4, and high school.
And while lunch ladies have a certain reputation,
I know, I'm used to it. Like I'm sloppy, yeah?
Lady, you're scared.
laughing.
Cafeteria Shuffle was my first song that I actually wrote.
Chef B already has big plans for her next hot lunch hit.
Shake and Bake is going to be my next bomb to release.
And after 2 years of a pandemic in which food service workers had to go above and beyond, working well over 12 hours a day, Chef B has one more verse for all of us on School Lunch Heroes Day.
School Lunch Heroes are the big or small. We're School Lunch Heroes. We stand tall. Because whether you see us in the cafe or in the hall, just that thank you. That means a lot to us.
So well said. Will Gans, ABC News, New York.
And Jenna is back in about